Well, Nate, Staniforth's Real Magic Tour, it's in Omaha this month, and the first show was last night.
Yes, and it sold out. He'll return to the Slowdown stage every Thursday throughout the month of March.
Nate's here. Nate, good to see you, bud.
Thanks
really
for having
great
me
great to meet you.
So how was the show last night? Last night was good?
It was a blast, yeah. It was fun to see everybody so excited about it.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. Okay, many fans first saw you on the Discovery Channel, right?
That's
Breaking
right, yeah.
Magic.
Yeah.
Was that a fun gig? How was that season?
It was wild. I'd never done anything like that before, and we filmed for 3 months in London. That was new for me, and when you're a live performer, you're used to looking out and seeing the audience respond. Mm-hmm. But it went out to 100 million people around the world.
Right.
But I couldn't see them as I was doing magic mm-hmm. for the camera.
But you're essentially on the streets, right?
That's right. Yeah.
How are the British when you're doing magic in front of them?
Oh, they were great. Yeah, they were great. There are some of the best magicians in the world are in the UK right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Your shows aren't like traditional. If people have been to like other shows before and they kind of think they know what to expect, how is what you do on stage different?
I think when most people think about magic, they think of laser beams and smoke machines mm-hmm. and tight leather pants and tough hats and rabbits, And there's nothing wrong with that. But
I don't see any leather pants here as we're looking at a video of you, Nate.
The thing I love about magic is how it can give you that experience of wonder and astonishment. And that's what the show's about. Mm-hmm. There aren't a lot of jokes. There are no special effects. It's just about giving people that experience of mystery.
Well, are you going to give us that experience you and that mystery this morning?
Do you want to see some magic?
We do, yeah.
Okay.
I understand you have a couple tricks.
Yeah, so I have something I want to show you, but it starts in sort of a strange way. All right, Mary, I'm going to have you help me with this.
Okay.
So I have something in my hand right now. I can't show you. I can't tell you what it is, but I need you to hold it for me. So hold, sort of make a cup with your hands.
Do I need to close my eyes?
Yeah, close your eyes. Look away. No peeking. I'm just going to put it in one hand. Seal your fingers around it.
Okay.
I did give you something. Uh-huh. I'm not just making this up.
No, I can feel it digging into the backs of my fingers.
Okay, so
Is it moving?
But it's kind of hard.
Don't guess, but just yes or no. Do you think you know what it is?
It feels like a piece of cardboard or something.
Okay, all right. So hold it in one hand, and with the other hand, I want you to just touch the back of any card here. That one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so when you go back and think about this when I'm done, I want you to remember, like you could have touched any card,
uh-huh.
but we've got King of Diamonds.
Yeah.
Listen, I want you to hear this. I'm going to tear a corner from the card. That corner is going to disappear.
What the heck?
Wow. No, I swear I watched that thing in your hand and it was just there.
But here's the thing. I'm a magician.
Wait, and your sleeves are rolled up. I'm looking for where this thing went.
I'm supposed to be able to make things disappear. So that's a good trick, but it's not magic.
That's the trick to me. That's
this
the trick.
Is magic. Look at this.
Just get out.
Right. Lock down the studio. Something's going
you're
on.
You're nuts.
Wow.
Look at it. It's the...
That's amazing.
All right, thank you.
How'd you do that?
I'm sitting 2 feet
How'd you
from
do that?
You, and I didn't see
it's cool.
anything
It's a good
happen.
Feeling, because I feel like most people see magic on screen, and you can always dismiss it as a camera trick or something,
uh-huh.
but you were right here.
Guys,
I saw it. I watched.
And I was holding it.
I watched the piece in
we
my
are,
hand.
We are completely live. There's no delay. This
right.
isn't... There's, and we're right yeah. here. We're trust us on this. That's wild.
Is
I'm
this
so
next
impressed.
One just as good?
Well,
yeah,
that was impressive.
Let's talk a little bit more about you and what you've got going on. Because
sure.
Mike mentioned the show, but then you also said a couple of words that stand out to me. One of them was astonishment.
Yeah.
And that's really what your book is about that's
right.
coming up here, right? This idea of finding it, of creating it. Why did you want to work on a memoir?
Yeah, I think when you're a magician, you get into magic because you love that experience of wonder. But one of the things that happens is as you get better at giving that to other people, it becomes harder and harder to find yourself. Because a magic trick isn't amazing when you know the secret. And after you do this for some time, you know the secrets.
Yeah.
So I wanted to put myself in the audience. I wanted to go out and find a tradition of magic where I couldn't explain anything.
Mm-hmm.
So I bought a one-way ticket to India and sort of went looking for street performers, and every culture
really?
In the world has its own
yeah.
version of magic, and I wanted to find that and sort of rediscover that sense of amazement for myself.
That's impressive that you would do that,
yeah.
that type of research.
Yeah.
But you also gave a TED Talk.
That's right.
And the TED Talk was called Creating Astonishment.
Sure.
What did you talk about?
I think when people, so with magic, the thing that it can do that nothing else can do. Like if you want comedy, you can see a comedian. If you want special effects, you can see a movie. Magic is uniquely special in that it can give people that sense of mystery and
mm-hmm.
astonishment. And so it was a talk about how that fits into people's everyday lives, and just, you know, what is it when you're amazed? What are you thinking when you see something and start screaming and running around and jumping up and down?
You can find that online, by the way, if you just search his name and TED Talk, it pops right up.
Yeah.
So Mike was leading us to that next illusion
a
moment
ago. You want to see one more thing?
Okay.
Okay. So this is one of my favorite things to perform for people. You're supposed to perform. It's a magic trick for children, so just pretend you're four for a second.
We can do that.
Yeah. We do that every day on the show.
Okay, good.
He doesn't want to hurt our feelings, but he's noticed.
He's like, yeah, I know.
Listen, I want you to hear this, right? Okay. I'm going to break the thread. Obviously, you can hear it breaking.
And I can see it.
Sometimes when I do this, I worry that people think I'm not actually breaking it. I want you to hear it. I want you to see it. So here's the idea. I'm going to take some of the broken pieces, and I'm just going to roll them into a ball. And you can see all the broken ends get pulled in. So this is the amazing part. If you take that ball of broken pieces and just squeeze, the idea is to try to get it to stick. And then Mary, I want you, to do this.
What am I doing?
Grab the bottom piece. Do it slowly so the ball doesn't fall off, but just start to pull.
It's put back together.
What?
Hey, stop it.
Here, pull it. See, it's real.
But the thing is, I can't, you know, magic is a trick, right?
Right.
Or is it magic?
No, I don't have magic powers.
Right. But it's a trick.
Yes,
and I can't
do.
Find.
That's a lie.
I can't figure out exactly where you put anything.
See, that's the goal. Like, the goal is to use the craft of magic to give people that experience.
Yeah. I want to see you live.
Yeah, thank you. So you can get tickets at realmagictour.com. I'll be at the Slowdown every Thursday this month.
I'd
love to have you.
Just stay there forever.
So you're coming here. Can we have you back every Friday morning after you do your Thursday night show?
I'd love to do it.
Nate, just come hang out. We adore you
every
online
Thursday
again.
In March.
Realmagictour.com. You can also learn more about him on Twitter and Facebook. It's such a pleasure to meet you, Nate.
Really glad to be here.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Love.
Yeah,
wow.
We appreciate it.
Man alive.
Guests in the Morning Blend start their day with coffee from Paris Gourmet, the official coffee of the Morning Blend. Learn more online at omahamorningblend.com. You still trying to figure that out?
Yes.
Let me see that string.
It's legit. Bella Shape, Pellaferm, Latisse, they're all available at Lovely Skin.
Yeah, and they each address something different. Who's a good candidate? Plus special savings coming up. Yeah, it's great.